This is the story of a lonely man from distant times, right here in this land. King Oswald had a rich and sumptuous life, but his heart still ached for one thing, a wife. He'd heard tell of a maid as fair as she was brave, whose father had turned down every prince or knave who had approached and ventured to impress. How would Oswald prove he was worthy of this princess?
"I can help you," said a voice, "but it comes at quite a price."
Ah, just what Oswald needed, some solid good advice. But who was this love professor, this great romantic maven? King Oswald was amazed. The person speaking was his raven. A talking bird? Whatever next? This really cannot be.
"I can help you," said the raven, "but I charge a princely fee."
The bird began, "I want a crown and my feathers dipped in gold, and then I'll get the girl," he said to the astonished King Oswald.
I accept your terms," replied the ever more bewildered king.
"Please take this letter to the princess and with it this precious ring." And off the raven flew, his feathers glinting from above, across many seas and many miles, searching for the king's true love. He flew through day and night. His tired heart was fit to burst. He heard the crying voices of his hunger and his thirst. He found a rock on which to sit, rest his wings and drink and eat, when suddenly he saw a mermaid swimming round his feet. She grabbed him, pulled him under. His heart was filled with dread. She made him dance and dive and spin all the way to the seabed. She gave him food and drink and treats. He felt fitter, rested, stronger. Then he escaped the mermaid's grip. He said, "I won't stay any longer." He swam back up, took one deep breath, and all at once took flight. He kept on flying onward as the day gave way to night. Daydreams and night dreams filled his head. He pondered his existence until finally he saw it standing proudly in the distance, the castle where the princess lived. But she was locked inside. The raven had to ask her dad if she'd be Oswald's bride. The dad said, "No, no way, turn back, have I made myself clear?" But from a high up window, the princess cried, "I've got to get out of here. Take my letter and this ring. Oswald has to set me free. Tell him to come back with his army and leave the rest to me." The raven left for home. But a fearsome storm blew in, and in the twisting, turning gale, he dropped the letter and the ring. There was nothing to be done but to shelter from the weather, bedraggled and soaked from the tip of his crown to the end of every feather. Oh, terrible fate! Now he could never grant King Oswald his dearest wish. But in an instant, the ring and letter were brought back by a fish. A hungry, exhausted raven returned, telling tales of the seas and the air, and fish and mermaids and castles, and the princesses who lived there. He said, "I'll give you this letter and this ring in my own sweet time. First, you must provide me with a feast of meat and bread and wine." After his meal and a rest and a bath, the raven felt much better, and gave the king the plan the princess outlined in her letter. Oswald and his army lifted their sails and crossed the sea. The raven and Oswald were ready to help the princess set herself free. Beep, beep, beep.